Did you know that Firefly Aerospace, known for its small satellite launches, is also developing lunar landers? In this video, we cover their lunar exploration ambitions and introduce you to Blue Ghost, their very own lunar lander. The Firefly lander is designed and built to be easily adaptable so that it can serve each customer's unique needs. Firefly is vertically integrated, meaning they design and produce their own components in-house. This strategy enhances efficiency, allowing for immediate feedback between the production line, quality assurance, and engineering teams. Located in a 50,000 square foot spacecraft facility, Firefly includes a mission control center and a spacious 2,500 square foot clean room. This setup enables the company to handle multiple lander projects concurrently, catering to various customer needs. Blue Ghost is designed, built, and tested in-house to support rapid mission schedules with less reliance on external supply chains. Firefly Aerospace is currently involved in three missions as part of NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services program, securing contracts worth $230 million. These missions are set to be completed in the coming years, positioning Firefly as a significant player in the NASA Artemis initiative aimed at returning humans to the moon. Details about the third mission remain elusive. It might still be in the planning or bidding stages. We'll provide an update once more information becomes available. Annual missions to the moon with Firefly's Blue Ghost lander. Firefly's Blue Ghost lunar lander is set to make annual trips to the moon, providing customized payload services that match the technology and exploration goals of each customer. It offers both rideshare opportunities and dedicated missions, allowing for the delivery and hosting of payloads across the lunar surface. When combined with Firefly's medium launch vehicles and orbital transfer vehicles like Electra, Blue Ghost facilitates a complete range of services from Earth to the Moon and into Cislunar space. Now, let's look at the technical specifications of this lunar lander. The lander is 2 meters or 6.6 feet in height, with a diameter of 3.5 meters, that's 11.5 feet. It can supply 300 watts of power for payloads and has uplink and downlink capability. The lander can carry 150 kilos, that's 330 pounds, to orbit, and 2,700 kilos with a transfer vehicle. The lander has a camera that supports 360 degrees of vision in high quality definition. Payloads can be mounted above deck, giving over 3 square meters of unobstructed horizon and sky views. Alternatively, payloads can be mounted on the mid-deck with shelf mounting options. This is a great option for rovers. Below deck can also be used, and this is great for unobstructed surface access. The lander is designed with stability in mind, featuring 4 shock-absorbing legs to handle the impact of landing. It also includes ACS thrusters, that's Attitude Control System, which deliver the subtle yet critical adjustments needed to orientate the lander correctly during its descent to the lunar surface. These thrusters are vital for avoiding any disastrous rotations or pitching, enabling a stable landing. They have also proven their reliability on Firefly's Alpha rocket, demonstrating their effectiveness in real-world conditions. For navigation, the Blue Ghost is outfitted with 2 navigation cameras, allowing for landing precision with 4 meters, that's 13 feet, showcasing its ability to autonomously select and land at a designated lunar site with high accuracy. End-to-end Cislunar services. The versatility of the Blue Ghost lunar lander extends beyond just using Firefly's own rocket. It can be tailored to launch with various other providers, much like how Rocket Lab's Photon satellite bus has been launched aboard SpaceX's Falcon 9. When it comes to prolonged operations in lunar orbit, Blue Ghost could be paired with Firefly's Electra orbital transfer vehicle. This partnership offers a range of services including payload hosting, space domain awareness, and support for interplanetary missions, allowing for more substantial payloads to reach the moon's surface. Milestones. Let's look at the milestones the Blue Ghost lander has achieved so far, and then we will finish with the upcoming events. NASA awards Firefly $93 million for a demonstration mission. Firefly was awarded a contract worth $93.3 million from NASA to deliver payloads to the lunar surface as part of the Commercial Lunar Payload Services Initiative. 10 scientific instruments and technology demonstrators will be delivered to the lunar surface in the first mission. Blue Ghost will spend approximately 45 days in transit to the moon, conducting health checks on each subsystem and carrying out some payload science. Blue Ghost will then land in Mare Crisium and operate payloads for a complete lunar day, that's 14 Earth days. Following payload operations, Blue Ghost will capture imagery of the lunar sunset and provide critical data on how lunar regolith reacts to solar influences during lunar dusk conditions. The lander will then operate for several hours into the lunar night. Payloads have been delivered and fit checked, with ongoing integration processes for the mission payloads being conducted by Firefly. The payloads on Blue Ghost Mission 1 will help advance lunar research and conduct several first-of-its-kind demonstrations, including testing Lunar Rock's sample collection, global navigation satellite systems abilities, radiation-tolerant computing, and lunar dust mitigation. These investigations will help pave the way for humanity's return to the Moon. The data captured will also benefit humans on Earth by providing insights into how space weather and other cosmic forces impact Earth, among other valuable research. Blue Ghost Mission 2. This mission, which is scheduled to launch in 2026, will visit the far side of the Moon. Firefly was awarded a second task order by NASA as part of the Commercial Lunar Payload Services Initiative. This time, they are delivering payloads to lunar orbit and the far side of the Moon using a two-stage vehicle configuration, including Firefly's Blue Ghost lunar lander stacked on a Firefly orbital transfer vehicle called Electra Dark. With payloads from NASA, the European Space Agency, and Australia, the far side of the Moon is a uniquely quiet region, shielded from noise originating from Earth. The Moon further shields noise from the Sun during the lunar night, making the region perfectly suited to collect valuable data on the cosmos free from any unwanted radio interference. The payloads flying on Blue Ghost Mission 2 will search for lunar resources and uncover new insights about the origins of the universe. Firefly's Electra vehicle will first deploy the Blue Ghost lander and the European Space Agency's Lunar Pathfinder satellite in lunar orbit. Blue Ghost will then touch down on the far side of the Moon with Fleet Space's Spider payload and NASA's Lucy Night Radio Telescope and User Terminal. Electra will remain in lunar orbit to serve as a comms relay and provide radio frequency calibration services for Lucy Night with a deployable antenna. There are still some payload slots available for this second mission. Upcoming events. Let's go over the upcoming events for the Blue Ghost lunar lander from Firefly. Blue Ghost launching in January 2025. As of the latest updates, Firefly Aerospace's Blue Ghost lunar lander was scheduled to launch in the fourth quarter of 2024. However, recent posts on X suggest there might be a delay, with discussions of a potential launch in late January 2025. Just as this video was about to be published, Firefly announced on X that the Blue Ghost lunar lander has successfully completed its environmental testing. It is now scheduled to be shipped to Cape Canaveral for a launch on a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket. The launch window opens no earlier than mid-January 2025 and spans 6 days. The second Blue Ghost mission is scheduled for sometime in 2026. Okay, that's it for now. We'll keep you informed with updates on Firefly's Blue Ghost lunar lander, and we wish them the best of luck on their missions. Be sure to subscribe to get the latest news on commercial space startups around the globe. From rocket launches to space stations, orbital tugs, lunar landers and more, if it's a commercial space startup, we cover it. See you soon.